So for the first question, compute the moment daw about the z-axis. So lahat ng moments natin dito will be bending moments, not twisting moments. So meron siyang rectangular components, 80 along the y-axis, 60 along the x-axis, and 70 mm along the z-axis. So yung length natin will be square root of, again, x is this one, 60. Y is, along y, ito, 80. Parallel sa y-axis. Z naman is 70. Parallel sa z-axis. Yan. So, 60 squared plus 80 squared plus 70 squared. Yan. So, yung length natin is, ano ba yan? 60 squared plus 80 squared plus 70 squared. 10 square root of 149. So, store ko na lang yan sa A. Yan. Kasi gagamitin naman natin yan sa lahat ng components. Yan. So, nakastore sa letter A. So, for the first question, compute the moment about the z-axis. So, for the z-axis, di ba, meron yan siyang components. Meron siyang force acting dyan. Yan. Ito yung force along y. Ito yung force along z. So, fz, fy. And then, we also have a force along x. So, paslant ba yan siya from here? So, parang paganyan. Compressive lahat. I mean, toward the body. Yan. So, for fz, again, hindi natin isasali yung tatama sa axis and also yung parallel forces. So, fz is parallel to the z-axis. So, hindi yan kasali sa magkukos ng moments. So, yan yung dapat mong tandaan. And then, wait lang. Sa taas ba to? Wait lang. Mz. Ito, meron siyang tama. Yung fz, hindi kasali sa magkukos ng moments kasi parallel siya sa z-axis. Yan. However, itong fx, it has a moment arm about the z-axis, which is itong 240. Yan. Itong fy din, it has a moment arm going to the z-axis, which is itong 100. Yan. So, isasali natin yan lahat. So, the moment about the z-axis is ano ba yung force? The force is 300 kN pala. So, yan. 300 kN multiply natin by the components. So, let's first consider fx. So, along x, it has a distance of 60. So, 60 divided by the resultant, which is nakastore sa A. Its moment arm is 240 mm. Yan. And then, yung fy naman, it will cause a, ano ba to? This will cause a clockwise rotation. Ito rin. Yung Fy, it will also cause a clockwise rotation. So, plus lang lahat. Yan. So, Fy is 300 multiplied by the Y component, 80. divided by the resultant, and then its moment arm is 100. Yan. So, moment about Z pala is 300 times 60 over A times 240 plus 300 multiplied by 80 divided by A and then times 100. Now, itong Y, although pag i-extend mo yan, tatama yan siya dito, hindi siya kasi tumama exactly sa Z-axis. Kaya meron tayong perpendicular distance. Kaya nasali yan. I hope clear lang. So, equal yan to 55.052, but we have to divide this by 1,000. Bakit? Yung distances kasi natin, naka-mm. But we need the distances in meter kasi KNM yung sagot dapat. So, we have to divide this by 1,000. So, divide by 1,000, we have 55.05 KNM. So, yung sagot pala natin is letter C. Now, how about for the second question? Ano yung moment about the Z-axis? I mean, X-axis. So, ito na yung axis natin. Consider natin yan. So, for the X-axis, yung moment dyan, itong Fy, meron ba siya? Fy multiplied by, wala siyang moment arm. Itong Fy, wala siyang perpendicular distance going to the X-axis. So, hindi siya kasala. Yan. And then, pag i-extend mo kasi yan, yung X-axis, yung Fy, tatama kasi yan sa X-axis. Parang ito ba? Yan. Extend mo yung line of action ng Fy, tatama siya sa X-axis. So, hindi siya kasala. And then, yung Fx naman, hindi siya kasala kasi this is parallel to the X-axis. So, yung magkakos lang pala ng movements would be itong Fz lang pala. And then, it has a moment arm of 240 going to the X-axis. So, we have Mx equals the force, 300 kN. Ikomponent natin, yung Z na distance is 70. So, 70 divided by A, yung resultant. So, nakomponent na natin yan. Ito na yung Fz. So, multiply natin by 240. But don't forget to divide by 1,000 para maging KNM. So, 300 times 70 over A times 240 divided by 1,000, we have 41.29. And this is KNM. Yan. So, letter B pala. Yan. Now, sa y-axis naman, isasali na lang din natin. Pag sa y-axis ka, magmo-moment, yung fx tatama sa y-axis, ito ding, itong fy din. Itong fy is parallel to the y-axis. Sorry. So, hindi yan kasala. Itong fz lang yung magkakos ng moments, and then its moment arm is 100 mm going to the y-axis. So, try daw natin. Instead of 240, gawin natin 100. And then, check natin pag nasa choices. So, 17.2. So, andito talaga. 17.21. So, isali na lang din natin. Yan. Pag MY yung gusto mo, then you have the same expression dito. Yan, but instead of 240, the moment arm going to the y-axis for FZ is now 100. So, magiging 17.2 KNM. Yan, isali na lang natin.